Do you need visuals for your presentations or documents? Let me show you an AI tool that will be able to create these just based on the text you already have, input it, and you'll get stunning visuals. And the best part is it's completely free to use right now. Let me give you some examples. Let's say you have a PowerPoint and you have this text written out. You can quickly input it into this tool in seconds, get a graphic that matches. You can also use this in Microsoft Word. You have your text, input it, and you're going to get another visual. If you're a Google user, use it in Google Docs to create the visuals. Want to add some pop to your Google Slides? Use it here. The product that I want to show you here today is called Napkin. It's at napkin.ai. I'll put the link down below in the description so you can click on it and go right to it. And like I said, it is completely free currently while it's in beta. You can check it out right here. To sign up, just simply go to the top right-hand corner and then use your Google or sign up with an email. Go ahead, get signed in, and then you can follow along with me. Let's go ahead and create a new napkin. I'm just going to simply click on New Napkin. I have two different choices. I'm going to start with a blank napkin, but if you draft with AI, very similar to using something like ChatGPT or Copilot or Gemini, it will write for you. And I'll show a demo of this after I do the blank one. So with a blank napkin, it will go ahead and create a spot where I can input text that I already have. Let's just give this a demo. Name here just for our purposes, and this is where I'm going to paste the text. So if I go to a PowerPoint and let's say I needed the graphic for right here, I'm going to go and take this text. I'm just going to go Control C, go over to Napkin and paste it in. Now, what I want you to notice as I hover over it, notice the lightning bolt on the side. So if I go generate visuals, I just simply click on this. Then it's going to show me a bunch of suggestions that I can hover over to see what I like the best. As I scroll down, you can see the different ones that are there, the different styles, and it's already pulled information from that short paragraph and put it into here. So once I find one that I like, let's say I like this one here, I can click on it once and it goes to next level where I can even choose more colors to see what I would like. I'm just going to go with this top one right here. Now, at this point, you can still customize it. Now, I can go up top. If you notice that I have different fonts, as I hover over it, shows the different ones. If you want to make those quick changes, we have our color palettes here that we can just quickly hover over and you can quickly change. We have brightness. So everything's very easy to customize with any of these. Now I can click on each of these individually too. I can drag things around. I can actually download components and work on them individually. So whenever you see this over here, this is a download option where I could copy it to the clipboard or I could download it. And if I wanted it to be on a transparent background, I could just turn this on and you can see how you can play with light and dark mode as well as the resolution. Right now it's a PNG. I have this in if I wanted it downloaded. Now that's just showing what I have selected. So with any of these, if I hop click on any parts, you can see the customization that I can do. If I wanted a different graphic, if I click on this suggestions, if I hover over it, it gives you an idea what it could change to. So you can quickly adapt to any of those. So hover over different things to see what you want. So how do you get this to your PowerPoint or your Word or Google Docs or Google Slides? What you can do is, and I'm going to make sure I have the whole thing selected here, and I'm going to go to this download option up here. So when I go ahead and click download, I want to have no background, so I'll turn it on so you can see the little checkerboard there so it's transparent. I'll just keep it at this resolution and I'll keep it in dark mode. And I want a PNG, but notice you can do a PDF if you wanted to download it as that as well. I could download this to have that file on my computer or I can do clipboard. So if I was going to go to clipboard here, go back to PowerPoint, and just go Control V, I have this graphic now and I can size it and place it where I need in PowerPoint. So the nice thing is it is customizable. I could have, you know, I could have changed the color of the font if I wanted it to be popping a little bit more on the white background. It depends on how you have things set up. In this case, I showed you PowerPoint, but with any of these graphics, as soon as you copy, you can paste them into things like Microsoft Word or maybe Google Docs. or even Google Slides just by that Control C, Control V. And remember, if you download it as an image, you can upload it to any of these plus even more. So let's go back to Napkin again here. I'm just going to close out and notice that if I click on Library, this is called Demo. And this is called Demo. So my napkins are going to be here as long with my recents. If I go and create a new napkin, I want to go with Draft with AI this time. With Draft with AI, what I can do, and you can see this format looks familiar to other chat GTP or Copilot, as I mentioned before, to create. I'll just use one of the practices, one of the examples that they have down here, but you could create your own prompt, and I'll just use this one and hit continue. Now, the Napkin AI here wrote me a brand proposal for a Green Thumb Plant Care Company. At any point when I hover over a section, notice the lightning bolt. So if I go down to pick maybe target audience here, if I hover over it, I can go and click on the lightning bolt and it's going to create a graphic for that section. So I could go through section by section. I could take this information and copy and paste it into a PowerPoint, Google Slides, or how I want to use it, and then go ahead and put the visuals that Napkin created. So if I go through, and I'll do this quick again to pick a few different examples here. We'll use this one. You have some options down at the bottom. I just want to point out with the labels, if you wanted to add a label to anything, you can use it there. You can sketch on top of this as well if you want it as part, and you can add an image. So you can upload an image from your computer, drag or drop it, and copy paste images. If I go back Control Z, it undoes the steps here. So if you want these again in anything else, you can go ahead and select. So if I go ahead and select this, and if I wanted to download it, I could download it to my computer, and then this would enable me to email it to someone if someone else was going to use it, or I could be putting it in any document or presentation that I need. A couple other options I want to show you before we leave today is if I take a look up at share up top, you can add people. Notice separate it by comma, and you can choose what level they can view or edit and share. It shows who the owner is. You can download as a PDF here or copy the link. If you want to work in light mode, you can switch up top, just click up here in the right hand corner, and you can quickly change back and forth. And you also have the sign up option. Under library, you can do some downloads here as PDF, duplicate or delete the napkin. And you can also add comments. So if you are sharing on this or making on any points to yourself, you can go ahead, add comments to this. So I hope you like this little walkthrough of Napkin for creating these visuals for your presentations and documents. Take advantage that it's completely free right now. I don't know how long this will last, but you can make some great graphics in the meantime. Thanks for watching this time on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.